10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Alliances.
Oga Magi!
Team Secrets, turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
War Chief.
Team Secrets, turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Slada.
Alliances, turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve.
Juggernaut.
Team Secrets, turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Alliances, turn to ban. Team Secrets, turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. Alliances, turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining.
I think these are two of the better teams.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah. Not so well known. A lot of like pub stacks that just happen to have good players. Whereas these
reserve time.
A lot of well known players that have been around the scene for a while.
Yeah, both these sides definitely have the fan base, it's safe to say. And Secret's now one of the favorites. Again, I've been kind of stressing this throughout. But Alliance, they're kind of one of these teams maybe we expect to make the playoffs, but honestly, they've been having some disappointing results as of late, and a lot of events have been happening. So I know they would love for it.
Team Secrets, turn to pick.
But they definitely a step up here as far as the matchup goes. But they got Juggernaut, Ogre Magi.
Yeah, I think the Ogre first is a little less common. I've
5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
witch doctor.
Alliances turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Crystal Maiden.
Team Secrets turn to pick.
Imber Spirit.
Alliances turn to pick.
Board like puts in a lot of work, especially on like some Juggernaut early on. Spinning in team probably doesn't have the Manta yet, just has the HOD working on that Manta. Get melted really quickly by the Death Ward and the Amp.
And a couple of picks there. You figure both mid options for both teams. The Ember Spirit coming out and then into a Magnus response. They went with that Magnus pretty quickly, so pretty certain that they wanted that pick. It seems.
Yeah, the Ogre Magnus and then right-clicking cores is something that is very, very popular in European pubs, and I think it's very strong. You just mega buff up these cores and have them be strong. You farm super fast with the Empower as well as the Bloodlust. They also, you know, scale obviously very well late game. You always have this RP, especially when you team fights. Although typically whenever you run a Magnus, you want to have some other initiator that can go in first. Magnus goes in second. So we can get a good RP, force things on just one or two heroes. And since the Alliance does have that Juggernaut, we'll see if they go for something like an LC maybe for Limp. I think it's some hero that they prioritize quite a bit and can be very nice to have with the melee and you know a hero that they've actually banned it out.
Alliance turn to ban.
We're having the same mindset there, so not wanting to give yet another buff to that Juggernaut especially, so take away the LC option, but now the final ban for Alliance, it will be a Spark, actually. A very quick silencer pick, so again, not using much reserve time. They're pretty confident with their draft.
Yeah, I think this the silencer pick is actually very good. It shores up their lanes quite a bit. The Ember Spirit and the Slaughter having the roaming potential on mid, it's a little spooky. I think you don't want some hero that lets the Ember have like a decent start and then he can kind of just roll up to the lane and punish whatever mid hero, and Silencer has a super good time versus in the lane. Because the Glaives don't pull aggro, you can just constantly right-click him down, and he doesn't really have an answer for it. He'll have a decent first wave, you can flame guard down the wave, but as it goes later and later, he's going to eventually have to retreat to the jungle, or people are going to have to
There's a curve.
Alright, so it's a little bit of an adjustment by Secret, not wanting to let their mid lane just get dumped on like that. So they give mid one the TA. It's definitely a very nice TA game. Only one here will have a pretty nice time in the mid game. It also is one of the heroes that can actually do decently well versus Silencer, a hero that's pretty well known for being sort of a 1v1 bodying legend.
About that. So the silencer. So where do we expect the silencer to end up? Where you're getting? Is this going to be a mid silencer even? Or?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a mid silencer. It's a hero that benefits quite a bit from the bloodlust. Not the most from the empower, but very least is a right clicking core, and it also gives you considerably more team fight. So if you don't have that second initiate to go in first, go in after, having the silencer, you have the Magnus jump in and then take away all that counterplay potential. You just jump in on RP and then global, and then you can sort of do whatever you want, kill that hero, fight can, you know, whatever happens afterwards. A very nice combo.
Roller from there, so I'm noticing too, Jonathan Fan actually shortening his name quite a bit. JSF, interesting. Nice for a while, but of course I'm familiar with several of these players, so it's always fun to see some names here. Let's roll the Juggernaut at the top lane, and a lot of early wards going down yet again. It looks like Slaughter got up here really quickly in the dire jungle. Got an aggressive ward. He roams, I guess.
I think they want to the lane up top with this dual lane. It looks like they are going to be doing that. It'll potentially keep this Ogre up top lane. If the Ogre doesn't come there, then I think they'll have a pretty nice time. The Juggernaut CM has a decent amount of kill potential onto the Centaur once Joe gets like level 3 spin, or he potentially gets harassed down, but as far as just sitting in the lane and last hitting goes, Alliance can only really full commit onto these heroes, or they're not going to be able to can only really kill them, or, you know, just leave them be. So the Ogre definitely wants to sit mid and mess with this TA, so they're going to take advantage of that and potentially punish top as much as they can on this Centaur. I guess Puppy has the potential to hang around mid, help out mid one, although I don't know how much he does really versus Ogre sitting there whomping on the TA while the arm.
Now he does have those boots first, of course, so of course the crush ready to go. Manages to sit in this middle lane as you're getting at it. It's going to have from the Ogre Magi right here. Witch Doctor, he's sitting up at the bottom lane. Witch Doctor, I feel like, has potential to go two kind of different builds. I mean, either the Voodoo Restoration route or the Maledict route. Is there either one you think more sense here?
I think he probably just gets like one or probably a value point for this game. I don't think it does that much. Alliance is all about jumping in and blowing up a hero or multiple heroes with the global and like taking these very, very quick fights. And Secret's sort of the same vein. They have two Blink Leaders. Flutter's Blink will come a little bit later, but they have a lot of burst damage. I think Maledict extra damage will put some mileage. A little different than usual, the Magnus. We've seen a lot of offlaners recently go with this PMS starting, and then just having the Tango. But actually goes for the Stout Shield and the two sets of regen, so a little bit easier to harass here. And Pilotite taking the Maledict level 1 is getting a decent amount of harass on him.
Yeah, usually not considered a very powerful tool, the Maledict level 1, but like you said, making him forcing out a lot of regen, really kind of the idea with that. Meanwhile, middle lane, mid 1 is finding himself being heavily harassed here. Yeah, Puppy, I mean, he's here, but exactly how much of a threat is he really going to be? Really proving right now it's not the greatest threat, that they're not afraid to run at that TA and do plenty of damage. So gonna be popping out the region himself and healing back up, but this is a very aggressive support mid lane here.
Yeah, it's actually a little interesting for mid one. A little bit of an adjustment here. It actually took the meld level 1 so we could dodge the ignites. Because it doesn't hit you whenever you go into invis. So took down the amount of harass he was taking a little bit. Like you said, the Slaughter helping him out level 1, so he is a hero that doesn't really like to have these random heroes sitting in her lane, likes 1v1s, he thrives in quite a bit, so not like super happy with the start getting right now, but eventually she would go into the jungle anyway once she gets, you know, 2 or 3 levels into her faction, so I don't think it's the biggest deal in the world, but it's definitely not what you want as a team.
Yeah, that Glaive harassment from Silencer proven to be really powerful as well. You talk about the idea that it doesn't aggro the creep onto him, so it's really abusing that fact and a lot of pressure again onto TA as well as the Ogre. So definitely a tough start, but again, keep an eye on that. You know, he progresses throughout this game. Covers more so. A Centaur has now made his way into the jungle. They're farming up with that double edge level 1 of his. Cover to clearly the top lane. Probably a little bit too much of an issue with that Crimson Maiden. Juggernaut bottom lane, meanwhile, Magnus. Oh, he's going to skewer, but he brings the MP with him on the Ember Spirit. Her auto attack and then the Maledict helping to tick him down. Still level 1, but more than enough damage there.
Yeah, I think that was a nice kill there. I think Alliance's supports really want to try and enable their cores early on, like we talked about. Whenever you run this Ogre Magnus sort of a strat, you want your cores to definitely be enabled. So the CM, I think, is going to babysit a fair amount, at least hanging around here. So if the core comes over, they have kill potential. They farm some hard camps in the meantime. Trying to pull some creeps. We're gonna actually walk. It'll be fine. Yeah, and then the enhanced skin camping mid with Glyph. So, try to enable these cores early on, but the Magnus is definitely gonna be left out in the cold as Puppy.
Yeah, way too much damage. Ignite even being level 2, actually. More than enough damage to help assist for the kill right there. And Silencer are throwing in some glaives with that wisdom and ends up getting the kill as a result. So, that ends it up at 1 girl to kill apiece now. But yeah, middle matchup. I mean, he is 10-5 inching all right. That's actually bottom lane. Pilot die. Gets some support from Puppy. The skewer in though will land, but does he have enough follow up? Has a level 2 shockwave. It goes off, gets the kill, but at what cost? Jonas and Fan going too deep, and he will end up dying in return. I mean, is that worth it? The fact that he gets the kill at least?
I don't know if it's worth it. It's probably not. The kill to Puppy, so it's speeding up the Blink Dagger a little bit. He'll get some levels off of that. I think at the very least, the Magnus gets level 4. Keizu actually gets to go on.
Runs down Crystal Maiden, and obviously Double Edge, plenty of damage. Level 2. Enough to get him killed right there. It's going for that 4-minute bounty rune, which I think Crystal Maiden did get, but obviously came at a cost for his life there. Now Puppy again being ran down. This level 2 Ignite doing so much damage alive for the auto attack. However, Hanskin maybe going too deep. He takes the cast down. The Malik is up. Level 1 still. But Haste Duty should be fine.
Yeah, it should be fine. But I think the amount of times this Mag gone down is a little bit worrisome for Alliance. He has actually put points into the Shockwave, something we haven't seen too much lately. We've seen a lot of players like Moon and Ice who've been playing this Magnus a little bit more in the offline have been going just for like 1 or 2 points, scaling up the Empower a little bit more, and then sort of going to the jungle.
Between Ignite and the shot and the Arcane Curse, I mean, just, he tried to meld right there to live, but obviously unable to. They have a sentry down anyways. He still dies. This middle lane really proven to do work, actually. And definitely, I know your suggestion that it's proven to be actually a good pick with that final pick, but... is it even doing better than you expected?
I think doing about as you'd expect. The CS isn't actually that amazing. 22 to the TA is 18, so although they have gotten the kill there and the TA is definitely not having a super fun time, it's constantly getting around down. He's actually CSing quite well in mid one, which is pretty impressive that he is doing this well in the lane. And I think it's, I think the silencer is doing decently well for himself. It's pretty important that they shut this TA down as much as possible. You can see Ogre sitting there for 4 or 5 minutes of the game. A lot of times they'll sit there and just sort of start the first wave and then rotate off. But shutting down this TA, I think, is probably the most important hero. Secret to be doing well. Hero that, you know, it's really their only response so much for this Juggernaut. They have the Amplify damage and the Death Ward, but that's not the greatest answer in the world. You really want this TA to come online, as she is basically all of Radiant's right click damage, all their power push. So I think they really want to play around mid one this game and give him as much space as possible. While the other heroes can sort of go around and do stuff. Ember Spirit, a hero that can, you know, safe laner that can make moves, reasonable amount early on. So I think now that this Magnus is gonna probably start retreating to the jungle more now that MP is 6, mid one will be able to free back to the jungle and just try and farm out some items.
Gonna collapse right here. The Omni Slash, all three bounces onto him, onto Casey, that is, and Flota will spin on top of him to secure that kill. So, good execution as far as the flank position being set up right there. Guaranteeing the kill onto the Centaur, and of course, slowing him down from progress, whatever he tends to go, either that Blink Dagger or now the Hood of Defiance. Did a pretty good on him, too. Of course, helps his farm potential. Good mitigation. Middle lane, though, signs of this could be a big kill. Will it happen? Global Silence comes out. It's not going to be enough to save him, though, but it might come in for some turn kills. Not enough damage, though. The Shockwave going through level 3, but Hanskin actually does get credit for the kill on Amber Spirit as the Ignite takes him down, running away. So they do get a turn kill when it's all said and done.
Yeah, it was really nice rotation for NP wrapping behind the tower to bring down the Silencer, and it's a core that does not come back very well. Talked about him being very, very good in the lane and control a lot of the low range heroes, but just right clicking down with the Glaives. But if he falls behind, if he gets ganked a lot early on, it isn't falling, isn't winning team fights consistently, then it's a hero that no defensive mechanisms, doesn't really build a defensive mechanism that quickly. This for the 4 staff, but that takes some time to get to. Before then, you're just sort of sitting ducks for any of these rotations from the Slaughter, from the Ember Spear up behind the tower, like we saw. So it's a really good rotation from Secret. And like we talked about, just trying to give mid one sort of a comeback into this game because they really need him to really start making things happen, take powers, take fights. Otherwise, they kind of have issues dealing with the Juggernaut.
Centaur is going to be going that Hood of Defiance first right here. So again, it makes up nice mitigation, but also helps with that farming, being the double edge magic damage in itself. He's getting a little bit low right here, but that does. Almost dead. And actually deny himself. There goes the shrine. Now that I also gonna as well. Figure the Blink Dagger to follow is probably gonna be Kizu goes for here. You're gonna pass up on a hero like Centaur, have that initiation, especially with the likes of Slaughter being pretty under farmed here. Dagger for him gonna be coming.
Yeah, I think Secret is content with just farming for now. The TA Kai wants to chill and get up to potentially her blink dagger as soon as possible to slaughter once it's level 6. Like you said, KZ working towards that hood. And I think Alliance, they really need to have a good start on these cores. I think both teams are getting an even start if they're farming about the same. And I think Seeker is probably fine with that as Alliance. They need these cores to be ahead because their supports are so dependent on the cores that if your Silencer is falling behind, if your Juggernaut isn't, you know, powers having the impact you want it to, these supports can just move very, very quickly for the TA. The Ember Spirit that get hunted down and just not really have any impact in these fights. They're very much dependent on the cores to do well. So I think it's very important that Alliance is enabling these cores early on. They're having good lanes, they're getting farms, or I think things can devolve pretty quickly for them. The Seeker just have really, really good ways to bring the cores down.
Now, we saw an Ember Spirit earlier in the dev, I'm playing on the match specifically, but it went a similar build where he passed up the idea to build a Discord because the bots first. Now, I know MP is playing a short lane Ember Spirit, to be fair, but what is your take on that, the fact that he's not getting that earlier on Veil?
I think going Veil this game is pretty mediocre. He's really the only magic damage hero on his team. If this Centaur magic damage, they have a TA, they have a Slaughter, so they're pretty physical damage oriented. I think it's much better that he gets these boosts out early on. He'll let him push up the lanes a lot better and so fights. As well as the movement speed being really nice. As far as staying out of range for these the RPs are just maneuvering a little bit better in these fights. I think you almost always want to go for the boot travel first on a safe lane Ember, or if you go for the Veil, then you end up being very, very immobile and you also kind of have a lot of issues.
That up here, and yeah, we don't expect him to get it later on, right? If he's not going to get it earlier on, then it's probably not an item to expect to see.
Yeah, I don't think so, especially with him going for the Wand and the Aquila. You don't typically see items. So. Very early game centric, and like we talked about, you kind of have slot issues. You don't really have room for you have to sell your bottle or your wand like early on, and it's not really items you want to sell if you're buying like that early on. There, these value items that you're only having them for 3 or 4 minutes. It's not really.
In your mind, is Battle Fury Ember Spirit not a thing anymore? Is that just not the same that it used to be, or is it still potentially something that could?
I think you could maybe go with a couple of items in, but I don't think it's ever really a first item. I don't think you can go Battle Fury. Boots Travel Battle Fury. I think you could make Battle Fury third or fourth item, depending on the game, if you need a little more physical damage. I think you can maybe go for this game, as they, you know, like we talked about, they are very, very physical damage oriented. And, you know, we also talked about Alliance kind of having catch issues. It's really what Ember wants. Ember wants a game where they don't really have a lot of lockdown. He's sort of free to do whatever he wants, so I think this is definitely a game on Ember where we could potentially build physical and thrive. If they really only have the empower, the RP into the global to bring down this Ember.
Top tower, heavy push coming out, taking advantage of the helm of the Dominator. You got, of course, the healing ward on top of that. Easily get the tower push as a result, so fortification going to be used to delay it just a little bit longer, but they're stopping that by any means. Tries to deny, not going to happen. Meanwhile, middle lane they come in, Arcane's Curse put out, but yeah, we're just going to walk it off. Managed to survive as well. Speaking of TA, how is he kind of recovered? Well, he started the game on it. He's actually better than the Silencer currently at top lane. Dampede activated, trying to make the play right here, going to go in, but no, not close enough. Slaughter makes the escape there, but yeah, TA is definitely recovered. Basically neck and neck with the sound.
Yeah, if you aren't able to kill this TA and her jungle take her mid tower early on, then she's here, they can just easily catch up on farm. Farms the jungle faster than most heroes will farm the lane, even if they're getting all the last hits. So like you said, it's catching up quite well, almost has the blink dagger already. I think the Centaur working towards his blink dagger at a reasonably decent clip to stack this camp up and has the hood, so they'll have several blinks online reasonably soon. I think Alliance taking that top tower is quite important. Lets them push it in and then maybe make some rotations on this mid tower, which they really, really want to take.
Got the empower here. What was that global silence, by the way? Blessings. He had to miss, because yeah, I thought that was actually the Arcane's Crypt, but no, that was the global silence, and nothing was really happening from what I can tell. So, I'm pretty sure that was a misclick there.
Yeah, that's
sucks.
That's pretty costly. It's with the TA blink coming up, it gives them Seeker a little bit of potential maybe to go for a move. The MP, like, just pushing bottom lane super far with Pilot Eye, because they know that Alliance They don't want to just start showing their heroes around the map. Secret will know where they're going, and they can farm with the Blink Dagger and the Slaughter, and they just have so much pickup potential in Secret between, like, the Slaughter, the Centaur, this Ember Spirit. They have all these mobile heroes with a lot of lockdown between them. And Alliance, you know, they have these two cores that can sort of sit in lanes and farm them out. Other than that, they really don't want to be showing just these swishy core buffing supports in the CM and the Ogre. Magnus wants to be off the map as he is their only catch, like we talked about, so the lanes are going to be a potential issue for Alliance, I think, as the game goes a little bit longer. Their guy at least has the Empower, so he'll be able to shove them pretty quickly.
Bottom lane, we do have a possible fight break now right here. You see Fire Blast attempt from Ogre Magi as he's coming to the flank. Landed on the MP. Do they have more, though? No, they do not. Remnant away. Stampede also activated, but yes, they do, with the RP coming out. However, Spirit, I don't think he's getting out of this one. Hey, he uses the Remnants, but he can't actually pour it to them. So well played right there, and that's a nice gank to be had, obviously, for Lance.
I think a little bit of a misplay from NP. Instead of running away with the Stampede, or maybe just miscommunication, he had tried to TP out, and then right whenever the TP got cancelled, the Stampede wore off instead of running or using that extra movement to get away with the Remnant. So a little bit of miscommunication until he realized the MP was going out, I think, and then he is going to go down, and off of that, they're going to lose the Tier 2 tower, or the Tier 1 tower, so we're trading for top at the very least, but I think Alliance is pretty happy with that, bringing down the Ember Spirit and getting the tower. The game has slowed down a lot, and I think that favors Secret quite a bit. It gives them time to get up these Blink Daggers. All the meanwhile, Puppy is farming that top lane, so already up to 1600 gold on the Slaughter. Gonna be getting a pretty good timed Blink. During he just had to sit mid up the TA early on, wasn't really getting any kills. But getting that free lane to sit there and farm, and have the Blink at a very good flip, and that's really worrying for Alliance. They're using this time to just 5-man down these lanes, do whatever they can, but eat.
So, he's in trouble, isn't he? He's gonna be caught, actually. Getting a little too comfortable right there. I was actually looking at the top lane and pushing in. I mean, how did that even start?
I think he was just getting cheeky trying to farm at the wave, but Alliance is going to take advantage of this. They really want to punish this window where Secret isn't ready to fight yet. They can't start splitting and not getting pickoffs, which they really want to do, and they have the HOV to heal him for. They're just going to start beating under this tier 3.
See the Bloodlust, that Empower is up on a Juggernaut. The idea of the lineup, you see, comes mid one there on TA to kind of put them off, and they will save the tier 3 tower just barely, but kill the Harpy. Benefit there with the cask still stunning him. Maybe get some is the helm of the Dominator creep, but gonna obviously again hold them off at the T3, but still a victory in a sword for Alliance right there, because with the kill on the Ember Spirit just prior to that, they're grouped up, pushing out together. And Juggernaut with a Manta style finish. I mean, he was clearing through jungle camps. Obviously, they made it a high priority to really have him farmed right here. Again, the idea of buffing up around him, too. Surely nothing queued up here, though. I wonder what his next option may be. I mean, Weasel, is it more the Scotty route, you think? What do you think, Juggernaut?
We'll see. I think it's worst Weasel game ever. We see most Juggernauts go for, like, the Maelstrom, it's Moner, and then more tanky items after that, typically. Loda will do some sort of unorthodox builds on Juggs, I think. A lot of times you don't typically see, so I'm kind of curious what he goes for. Getting this Manta early on is huge, though, I think. They really want to, like, start 5-manning down these towers, but that really early Manta, like, super allows them to do that.
Oh, they're gonna catch MP once again. The Global Sign's coming out. Can he rim it in time? I don't think so. And the lockdown is just too much, starting with that Global Silence. They just have way too much follow-up. The RP, sure, double ultimate used, but this is probably one of the bigger outside of TA targets that you're definitely happy to be killing here.
Yeah, and I think that original death on bottom, a little bit of miscommunication, they were able to take the tier 1, then another death by NP, they lose the tier 2, and it sort of snowballed into losing quite a bit of map control, having one tier 2 down as well as all their tier 1s. Very valuable mid tower going down, so TA gives her considerably less control over these ancients, so we'll be able to farm up a lot less quickly. Just working towards that death, so we'll have it pretty quickly, but they wanted to split the map, they wanted to get pickoffs. Slaughter with the TA while the Ember Spirit pushes lane super quickly. Centaur can push lane really quickly, but falling behind all this much, Alliance just has so much 5-man potential with the Joe getting the crazy early Manta. It was like 15, 16 something. You really don't have to kill him whenever he has that Manta, so Alliance definitely wants to keep up the 5-man pressure. They're all sort of grouped around here, shoving out these lanes and not showing on too many heroes. They have a smoke on Hanskin, so they want to go come up and fight. They're definitely very, very strong in these 5-man fights. They don't have the global, at the very least. And Secret trying to take advantage of that by going for this Roshan. I think this is really, really good. They don't want to let Alliance take a team fight, get this Roshan, and then just sort of walk down a lane, which is really the best thing Alliance can do right now.
Nope. Pop out, MP, the first target. Okay, no global science suspension, so maybe not as threatening. Roshan just about dead. He's going to be falling right there. He's just going to be picked up by mid one. There's an anti-stall used from Loda. Top of the Syrian chains, counter crush though, or on a Juggernaut, trying to chase him down. He popped the Omni Slash, a lot of jumps on MP, no one nearby to help him. And down goes Ember Spear. Meanwhile, Skewer back onto the Centaur. And that's going to be a double kill for Loda. The positioning just felt a little off there. MP, he honestly just seems on another page from his teammate somewhat. Highlight, I also going to be picked. 3-0. I mean, they have the Aegis on TA, but definitely think a victory for Alliance there.
Yeah, and with those heroes going down, it looks like Jug is going to go through that sky, he's going through that tanky route, but they're just going to be able to continue to 5-man. They're probably even going to get the tier 3 bottom and it is low, and they'll have access to those shrines and even more map controls. They still have the global up as well, so it's kind of hard for Secret to open in, as they can always be able to turn the fight around. Still have the RP as well. Alliance in a super good position right now. They could be threatened the racks even.
At least the tier 3, of course, is mentioned fortification. But now delaying it a little bit longer. Okay, maybe not a tier 3. Oh yeah, they're playing it very safe. Rush attempt gonna be just short right there for Puppy. RP is ready to go for Magnus though. You know that he is tempted. Back in if they were gonna commit to anything, but they do not. So they play pretty safe considering the circumstance. Again, they were fighting into an Aegis though, I guess. So the last thing you want to do is really kind of throw yourself at them and then all of a sudden give them all that hope. Not going to be able to get shrines. Downside.
Yeah, it was. I think it's very good patience play from Alliance. They know their 5-man is extremely strong right now. Secret get some random pickoffs. You know, Alliance sticking around a little too long on the high ground and beating away at kills is exactly what Secret wants. So I think they're doing very good restraint there, and that's what they need to do.
So Magnus going to maybe get the RP off a 4-step away. The skewer, it's still not enough. Wow, mid one will finish him. Also, the Slide of Fist assisting. They're coming out, Stampede offensively, trying to chase down the silencer, but he's a little too far away. That will be the only kill, and now the tier two tower being pressured. There's a Blink Dagger now purchased by the Ember Spirit, meanwhile. Juggernaut, he's lining up, ready to go, but without Magnus, they definitely feel a lot weaker when it comes to their initiation.
Yeah, and this is exactly what Secret wants to be doing. They want to start putting these lanes, getting the pickups with the Slaughter. It can jump in and blow heroes up extremely quickly. That's what they wanted to do a lot earlier in the game, but feeding away some of those hills sort of gave Alliance a window to play this game. Play the silencer. They haven't seen too much. Kind of just sat mid, farmed the lane, and they picked him as a lane counter to this TA, but whenever the TA can just retreat jungle, farm up and be just fine, it ends up being a little bit less effective than you want. So he only has the Hurricane Pike ground right now compared to TA's Blink, Deso, and DK buff pickup on mid one. So they have so much map control on Secret now. They've taken the least tier 2s, and they have a lot of considerably more mobile heroes than Alliance. So I think Alliance isn't able to find a fight if they aren't able to look for that 5-man team fight where they're able to, you know, like, charge towards the buildings afterwards. And they're going to start getting out farmed slowly. And Secret is very happy with that as they have a lot of pickup potential as well whenever these lands are starting to get out.
He almost found it there, but dagger away in time. That item he just got again, and just worried about more farm once again. He does have the Eye of Scotty queued up, already one of the ultimate orbs purchased. Almost there, being a little bit beefier and trying to help with the empty kite factor. Oh, but what about Magnus, by the way? Again, going that 4-staff route, now the Yule's on top of that. I know they're kind of all in on this idea that Juggernaut's their massive damage, and then their Silencer providing a bit, but even Silencer going at the Shivas here for Game 5 first, but is it maybe, I guess what I'm getting at with Magnus, like that Echo Saber more of that semi-carry build, the Shadowblade Echo Saber style would have been better? Or?
I think whenever you have these two farm-dependent cores, like the Silencer and the Jug going, right-click build yourself ends up being you try and take too much farm on the map, but you don't want to be showing on this Magnus as well, because you are the only hero with catch. Going for these right-click items, showing on the map all the time, give Secret the freedom to just sort of walk around and do whatever they want on the map. So I think it's actually very good that he's going for this Arcane's sort of selfless build, the Empower Your Core, that ends up being a farmer himself.
Finally get the tier 3 tower, the third time going in for it, and third time's a charm here. for Alliance, and again, a very patient team. This is what they're definitely known for as well. Get the tower kill, and now they know shrines are vulnerable, so they're gonna go for said shrine for the bottom at least. Up eventually, so good objective control coming out from Alliance, and again, good patience being shown as we're talking about the. Look at this net worth chart though, it's about 5,000 lead at a point for Alliance, and it dipped down to almost even, and now a little bit of climbing back in their favor, but yeah, one more misstep could definitely start putting Secret ahead, as you're suggesting earlier, especially with this TA. What, the BKB 2800 mark?
Yeah, I think sort of one of the only flaws in Secret's lineup is the Knot's like doing really well, if they're not like quite far ahead, and they have a very, very hard time going high ground. They kind of need to pick off and easy to get some jump.
That sucks. Still for him. He was running around for a good 3 or 4 seconds right there on top of him with the invis, and is like just wanted to find the right moment. That was not the right.
Yeah, he actually body bought him a little bit, so MP knew and remnanted away, or blink. I forget which one he did, but. Yeah, I ended up botting up, blocking him a little bit. Wanted to time it with the global afterwards. I think maybe waited a little bit too long. I think he could have just RP'd, and the global being 5 seconds, they would have had time to bring him down. So again, maybe a little bit of miscommunication. Gaber lives. They use the RP. They are all 5 man in this lane. Secret Knot super set up, and they may try and take this tower, but maybe the last shrine, and gonna be forced to come back as TA is split pushing. Secret. I think those kills early on, the MP gave up, losing a lot of that map control. It hurt Secret quite a bit. The window after that, where they sort of move out on the map and look for pickups, but now they have the Scotty on the Ember Spirit. I mean, on the.
Kind of, they missed the crush, and even if he hits that, though, I don't think they're killing the Agnes, right? Yeah, the Scotty on the Ember Spirit. TA, again, he has that butterfly queued up. In fact, has the Eagle Song in his backpack here.
Yeah, I think Alliance is 5 man now, which is so strong. Having the Scotty, having this Magnus on high ground defense is just almost impossible to push into. The Silencer having the Hurricane Pike as well to protect people back.
Oh wow, he's popping the BKB. He's being chased down. That's wide. Lodo's going to get kited meanwhile, so end up turning around. Handskin, unfortunately, not the same way to be able to run away. Scott with the Searing Chains, but Blink Dagger away from the TA, realizing that they were committing fully, and there's that global silence, unfortunately, resulting in nothing there. Nice bait out.
Yeah, they were looking for maybe some kills on the end of it with TH. Jonas Fan. I mean, Hanskiba has so much armor as well as the solar crest on that poker, and they're actually gonna smoke up and look for a fight.
Well, baiting going in, has that freezing throw ready to go, but look at the retreat from Secret, being patient, waiting for that spin to wear off if anything. RP is good to go for Magnus, so perhaps the depth aware of that. In fact, Ember Spirit, he's already porting out. Just have a remnant down, so could come back in if need be, but they're just going to simply avoid Alliance right now. They like the idea of a split push here between the TA and the Ember Spirit. They feel like that's going to be their way to win here.
Yeah, he's actually going for the Butterfly in mid one, and they really want to wait for this next Aegis. That's where their win condition right now is, getting the Aegis, getting the Butterfly, and then maybe trying to break high ground with that. If they don't have those items, then it becomes super hard for them to break the high ground, and I don't think this is a game where they want to go late game, super late game either. The Magnus versus Juggernaut with the super strong team fight of the global, and the Juggernaut just as smart as he is. It's very, very hard for them to actually break the high ground. Ember Spirit going for this Blink Yules. Yules actually lets the purge off silences and play a little bit more aggressively, but it's not like we talked about, he's not going through more of a physical damage transition. Not incredibly farmed right now, a little bit behind the silencer. So I think Secret, they want to get the butterfly, they want to play around this Roche pit and use that timing to potentially break high ground right now.
Going in the freezing kill button. Oh, he's able to blink dagger first. But it would cancel it, but he gets the animation off and gets away. Yule Scepter initially comes out right there. So Yule Scepter in general pretty popular this game. Or has one of his own.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, I think that's all. I guess just those they coming into play here.
Yeah, you don't want to let the silence do its work. It's also very nice versus Frostbite versus the glaives of, I mean, the arcane curse from Silencer. Several things you could purge off, as well as the silence. So, generally good Yules game. Secret just continuing to split out these lanes and play around this rush. really, really want that next Roshan. It's super important for both teams. If Lions can get it, then it really nerfs Secret's win condition, which getting that, getting the Aegis, potentially breaking high ground off the pickoff from the Slaughter or the Centaur. And if Alliance gets it, or if Secret gets it, that's definitely what they want. They want to, they want to try and win with this Aegis, and they see it's up. NP actually forces up down to bottom. He still has the TP up, but Roshan dies super quickly.
Yeah. Damn. Second Roshan kill at this point. Now they do get a pickoff elsewhere on the Witch Doctor in the top lane, so it almost got to be a sacrificial lamb right there, a bait of sorts, but here we go. The 8 is up. Gonna jump on it. Loading. Here comes the RP though from Jonas the Fan, and the Shockwave on top of that. The Blade Fury, the Science obviously being used as well. And down goes Slaughter, but mid one, he's still feeling pretty comfortable. Gonna hide to that melt for the time being. He has the Aegis, remember, gonna be popped right here. Jonas the Fan will lift the back, and obviously he's bouncing around. But the freezing field put down. They did pick off Ember Spirit, and now the melt for mid one, but can he actually escape from this?
They have no detection.
They really have no detection. Wow. Shockwave maybe? No, he blinks, and he's going to actually live. I mean, that's just that's definitely a bruise at the end right there. But
he just brings out dust.
Just got it. I mean, they won the fight, but that's definitely stinks.
Yeah, it's kind of unfortunate. Losing the Aegis like that is really not what you want. And NP's impact, you can really just starting to fall off. Only having this Yules and Blink. Juggernauts is not a hero that cares about an Ember Spirit, which is this level of muscle magic damage. They have the global, the sound, so you can fight the Ember away, and it's actually pretty tanky now. I think Alliance pretty happy with their position, and now Secret losing that Aegis, they want to just play around, they want to try and get these pickoffs, take these small skirmishy fights where they can get the. They're not doing that, the team fight from Flash is stronger.
Manskin is kind of just sitting here, he's a lot of evasions coming out actually with that Solar Crest. He will end up dying, but in the background, the Juggernaut will make his way out, realizing that there's more there than there was in the beginning, so not gonna delve vulnerable, so that will be a support pick at least. The Ogre, but again, the Solar Crest, also those Drum, so quite the unique build actually on the Ogre Magic. Gone, but a lot of abilities. It kind of fits the theme though, they're going a lot of these heavy R items and support, you know, you got Limp even once you got the Silencer, you can win that Shiva's in first.
Yeah, they want to make sure they can survive that initial jump from Secret. They're continuing to hunt around, they want to look for these pickoff kills. They can maybe go higher ground as MP's pushing its top, so they have a place where they can go if they do take a scrappy fight.
I'm gonna force staff over the ledge, but mid one still putting in those right clicks. That Shiva's has been getting plenty, but not enough damage to really get the support from him. Stampede, meanwhile, activated the Omni Slash on top of him. The whole time, they do get the pickoff as well, and a Crystal Maiden in the background. Now, Loda could be in a little bit of trouble, as here comes mid one with the auto attack. The Psyblade to use. Centaur is picked up with the spin, though. And Jonas and Fan helping to finish him off with the RP, but MP on the chase. Loda still healing up, though, with the heal ward. Magnus willing to fall in the auto attack. Not in time as he blink daggers forward first. Well, get away right there. 3-for-2 number wise.
Yeah, mid one is just destroying everyone. This butterfly pickup is so good. It makes it so the Juggernaut really can't bring out his refraction ticks immediately. So he's able to blink away a little bit more freely, having those refraction ticks always up. Like not getting canceled. Mid one's just going totally ham on several heroes in that fight. And that's exactly what Secret need. They need to continue to find these scrappy fights. Mid one have the freedom to go around and look for the heroes he wants, because if RP goes off, they RP the TA and he just gets right clicked down immediately, and then the rest of their heroes don't really have any damage, so pretty important that they enable mid one, that he has a really good time in these fights because he is basically all of their damage.
I gotta say, as far as MP is concerned, I mean, he really does feel underwhelming with how much he truly has. I mean, he just got the Maelstrom delivered, so obviously some benefit there, but again, it's really been much more of the defensive mindset as stressed earlier with that Yields pickup especially. Got the blink on top of the boss, again, no Veil even earlier on, so not necessarily any damage from that. Again, has the Maelstrom now, so her right clicks a little bit better, but you do look at the net worth, it really is a race between Juggernaut, the TA, Juggernaut even slightly more ahead. That Skullbasher finish and the Abyssal Blade come next to yourself. Having that favoritism as far as his farm is concerned. Overall, though, I mean, the net worth chart, again, this is a very even game, slightly going in favor of Secret overall. And too much at this point, so it could be anyone's game most incredibly here.
Yeah, and I think this game is going to sway back and forth. There's some, like, pretty interesting timings. Alliance is going to get really, really, really tanky, and their high ground defense is going to be very good. I think it's hard for Secret to really do anything. come a few minutes, whenever they get, you know, the Abyssal Blade, which they have now on the Juggernaut. Agnes has the RP now. I think Secret's in a pretty rough spot as is, but I think as the game goes a little bit longer, the supports of Alliance start to become just food for this TA, and it's going to sway back and forth between, I think, Alliance Hero being very squishy, and then, you know, if they get to that point where they're very tanky, then Secret isn't able to blow up these heroes on Strategic Competitive, just so superior. As long as Jonathan Fan hits a half-decent RP, that I think Alliance sort of mop up these teamfights.
Has been kind of 50-50, to be honest, but obviously he had the big one in a couple of fights prior to this that really set Alliance up in a good spot after that Roshan kill that was here at the top side. Secret felt a little too confident maybe with that Aegis, but the big RP not only stalled some things, but set up the turn for Alliance. So I'm 16-9 right now. Again, not the most active game when it comes to hero kills. A lot of avoiding at this point, but back to it still being a game that either team most certainly has a chance in. The Shadow Blade being worked on by Magnus, by the way. The idea of possibly that earlier, more so for initiation purpose, also getaway tool if necessary, but it will help with a little bit of damage output too. And then you got the Abyssal Blade, though, finished on Juggernaut. About a target that's so scary. I mean, even just these items alone is scary, but then you throw in the Empower, the Bloodlust, so much amp damage coming out. So they're going to feel confident enough to start sieging now, it looks like. A little late at least, or get the creep wave up there.
Yeah, they can use the spin to maybe bring down buildings a little bit. Secret not super set up right now, so I'm actually going to be able to free to walk up to the high ground. They're going to get these ring tracks.
No TP on TA. That's why, I mean, she has one, but it's on cooldown, obviously. So, definitely a wide crystal made it. Ooh, got crushed right and she got four staff, though. Be fine.
Secret want, I mean, Alliance want to continue to aggressive. They want to use the CAs with the Juggernaut, just basically unkillable having the Scotty and the Abyssal Blade. They want to push that advantage as much as possible. Try and potentially chip down these racks like we saw them do there. They're very, very strong right now. They have a smoke and it looks like they're going to... Well, they don't actually have one up here, so they're just going to camp around this area, keep up these lanes, and farm up Secret's jungle. Maybe try and get some of that slight net worth advantage back into their favor. They sort of have all their eggs in that basket, so while he's very, very strong, they want to abuse that as much as possible and try and... advantage. They do range racks, but at this point, not really super meaningful.
Slaughter just kind of poking the bear a little bit right there. Grass is Loda, but we're not concerned. In fact, Loda's trying to run them down, but poking the bear, able to get away though for the time being. But once again, going to kind of abuse the fact that sending the creeps up middle lane and perhaps work towards the bottom where that melee rack is ready to go. But what's the pressure now on the tier 3? Bloodlust applied to the Juggernaut, but again, that Abyssal Blade ready to go. You got the split push top lane coming out from the TA. Work on that eventual Bloodthorn, you figure. Work it queued up, but bit off of that, about 32 gold saved up currently. But yeah, you definitely right that they've been all in the basket here of Loda on this start. And I kind of feel like that's Alliance strategy as a whole. Really, no matter even the draft, the 4-1 idea, you know, you really buff up Loda here as the carry. To play that supporting cast around him. I mean, you've kind of been looking at farm, he's just taken everything for the most part. I mean, Silencer's been able to do decent, but he's 12,000 less net worth than that.
It's just not a hero that can farm lane super reliably. Because Seeker has so much pickle potential, it sort of forces Alliance to walk around as five heroes, not able to farm near as much as maybe they'd like to. Magnus, potential to farm around the map that gives you. Seeker actually split pushing a decent amount themselves. Power bottom, so they're gonna have access to these shrines. The mid one immediately hooks it towards them. They're gonna try and bring this down.
Power kill, and yep, he's in the shrine. I do it by himself, he has more than enough damage to do so. MP, meanwhile, chains up to kind of protect the shrine kill from happening, or to happen, that is. There. And Ember Spirit now gonna port elsewhere. That Octarine Core is actually almost finished. He is level 21 now. It's TA 25, yep, by the way. 24. Looks like at this rate, should be the first one to hit level 25, and you got, I guess in the plus 3 refraction instances here, or what?
Yeah, I don't think there's any scenario in which you ever don't take that. The Juggernaut especially not having the, MKB actually going for a butterfly of his own, so opting to be even more tanky instead of a little bit more kill potential on the TA. He doesn't really need that MKB, because if the TA is getting RP, then she's going to get her refractions. Charges burnt down almost definitely, and that will die extremely damage. Also having that cleave. will be able to hit on one of the other targets, but not really caring about the evasion too much. Like the going the butterfly and the juggernaut and the MKV. Yeah, I think you go for the three refraction charges. I think mid one's been playing extremely well this game, only going down the one time mid. Ignite and the King Curse very, very early on in the game, but is having kind of a rough start. Has farmed very, very well, has been super elusive, hasn't gone down anymore. And it's one of Secret's like glaring hope right now. They can push full alliance around the map, they can maybe find some pickoffs, even the alliance is 5 as of now. Hey.
Go the cheese, making it a little more tempting right here, and immediately Juggernaut starts going away with the auto attacks, but then Empower assisting with the bloodlust again, all the buffs. It's gonna happen pretty damn quickly. Meanwhile, what's going on over here? They catch Magnus, actually. That's what was going on, so they give up the Rorschach. Can it be stolen? Oh, that was close right there. Picked up, though. Now the bottom lane, though, they need to push it in. Like the decision from the Radiant side, at least. But Hans gonna be stunned in the front ground. That's a very vulnerable spot. He will end up falling. Double kill for it. One. No buyback, by the way, on Magnus. Slaughter caught off to the side there from Loda. Uses the Yule. But that's just gonna delay the inevitable. Although the Stampede comes out, the Omnisize bouncing around. KZ though, has that axe and mitigating some good damage right there. The Glamour Cape used as well, trying to simply live through this. He actually will end up living to spin away from Loda. But Rax will stay alive throughout it all. Now mid one, he's not out of the woods just yet, actually.
Yeah, no detection again.
Just on them, huh? I guess Magnus was the one that maybe had it. Oh, he didn't even have it on him. And they really need that. Us there. I guess they have a gem and ogre. Okay.
I don't think they would have killed the TA regardless. He had 5 or 6 refraction picks still up and the butterfly. So yeah, they go in. They get a couple kills here and there, but the Juggernaut really is so unkillable. Impossible to bring him down. He can just stand on the front lines. Secret. You see them just constantly jumping around, killing support cast, the CM going down here and there. The ogre. I don't think actually. Okay. Yeah. So he died and then bought back in that fight. So yeah, Secret just jumping around and killing the supporting cast heroes of Alliance, but very, very hard for them to bring down the Juggernauts. 7-0-4. So far, Secret really don't have the most damage. The TA, definitely not anything to scoff at, but whenever you have the 25 armor, the butterfly, and 3k HP on the Juggernaut, dodge attacks with the Manta, it's just very, very hard to bring him down.
Double damage through TH, dropping the second and final shrine here. On the side of Alliance, so played and all shrines on either side have now been destroyed. Actually, our towers in general, not much to work with for either team. Flip push of MP, top lane before quickly getting back the remnant. And he does have that Octarine Core finish, by the way. 600 gold saved up on him, but got a big note about last fight, too. Again, picking off Magnus like they did with no buyback. Without Magnus, they really just lose so much, not only with the Empower buff, but of course the RP initiation. That really is their only initiation one. Definitely need him if they want to be able to be successful in said fight. So that's why Team Secret is definitely feeling very confident pushing into the base despite giving up the Roshan kill right there. So, but in the Rax, ain't alive. Alliance now moving on through with a Shadow Blade. Not just a fan. They want to wrap around bottom lane. So this TA, of course, doesn't look like they're going to catch him.
Yeah, this game is all about finesse for Secret, playing around the Alliance heroes, dodging them around the map, still pushing lanes like we can now. Trying to find pickoffs here or there. Their fights need to put played very, very clean. Jumps in and out, blowing up P heroes, and just doing it over and over again. Not getting caught by the RP. It's very execution based. The rest of this game is going to be Secret. Didn't hit that window where they just have this killable TA, they get the Aegis, and they just sort of run at you. Take these team fights for free. Losing some kills early, losing map control, and now it's a lot of just about finesse. The Alliance fights are a lot easier to execute. Absolutely, just they're gonna up in the front line, hitting buildings, hitting heroes, and the Magnus always off. Out of vision has Shadow Blade now as well, so makes it even easier to hit that RP. And if he ever makes a mistake, he hits that RP and all kind of evaporates. So I think Kingsford definitely has the harder late game to execute.
The Gamer Spirit is able to make the initial escape and gonna keep on going, maybe an RP? All the yields, here's a chance. Remnant again though, he keeps on going, he's just so mobile. And he will eventually make the getaway. Middle lane, they try to go to Centaur instead, but obviously he reacts too, and simply can't catch anyone, but they say, you know what, we're here, might as well go for the push. Pressure stall a little bit, just split push bottom lane coming out between TA as well as the Ember Spirit, but it manages Elias to go into the base, say, you know what, you're going to have to defend, guys, so. Pressure on the melee, Rax, pressure temp, going to miss right there, Loto looking to go back in, but the ult after throws him in the air.
Healing ward is still up.
It is. Getting plenty of damage, healing them up, the freezing field being cast in, but the four staff away. Actually, Slaughter will be fine, so not the greatest freezing still coming out. TA, meanwhile, he's wrecking the Rax at the base back there. He got the bottom, and now he's going for the middle tier 3 tower, so the stall's actually working out pretty well. Although the melee Rax in the middle lane will end up on the range Rax, we have a bit of a race on our hands now. These two teams, but Elias, they are going to try to start fall back. TP's coming out.
Exactly what they want.
Yeah, they're going to catch them somewhere. The global silence is used, though. Juggernaut now going back in. The Omni Slash, and he cuts through MP. Gets the kill on him in, and he does have a buyback. In one, in the background. Going to blink forward, though. Trying to chase, but a nice Fire Blast multicast coming out. Although Puffy will stall them a little bit more. Magnus in the background. He has an RP still, by the way. Double kill coming out for Loda as he picks off Slaughter. And now they catch Centaur as well. Rakip is not going to save him, most likely. RP is still ready to go. He wants mid one, of course. He's hunting for him, but not going to get the angle. Alliance able to hold this fight, and they're going to be able to start pushing in now.
Yeah, they have no way to kill this healing ward. Everybody's healing immediately back up to full. MP's trying to ride in the base at the very least. The melee racks coming close to about half HP, but Hudson's gonna go back and try and slow us down a little bit. They're gonna get 2 sets here.
Yeah, they're just playing the game of stall. The RP is actually gonna whip right there, unfortunately. Now, maybe one pops BKB. Go for the turret kills. Load up. We'll fall back again. And somebody forwarded back. That would be the Ogre Magi. Oh, did the MP get too far up? He did somewhat, but he's able to get out once again. The stall game. Attempting, but it ends up being 2 sets of racks going down in favor of Alliance, and the middle racks does stay alive for them as far as defensively. Ultimately, they come out on top there.
Yeah, it's just so hard for secret fights. They have to play these fights so carefully, constantly going in and out. You can see Puppy probably blink stun 10, 15, but it doesn't really matter because they can never, ever full commit. They always have this RP to counter the GA to counter global, and they can't hunt for this Juggernaut almost ever. Ever blink in on the TA, then he just gets RP'd, and they waste that time where the Juggernaut's stunned and the Juggernaut's stunned, just kills everybody. He's so farmed 9-0 and no deaths on Loda, and has the Moon Shard as well, so it's basically 6-slotted on this Juggernaut. Just has the Moon Shard travel 2 to get upgraded. It's just extremely hard for him to fight.
MP really wants that kill on Crystal Maiden, and he's going to get it, actually. Well played right there. Burn is successful. So Crystal's dead for a minute. No buyback, but again, it's not really the prime target that you're like, oh, Crystal's dead. Let's go ahead and push now. So, in the case necessarily. Loda, you mentioned basically full inventory. Bots level 2 is pretty much the only upgrade that he could do. There's the backpack. I guess what? I mean, a refresher in the backpack could potentially be decent. That Omni Slash.
Yeah, I think that sort of gets into hypotheticals, though. It makes once the fights are getting to that sort of a stage. All these backpack theoreticals, it doesn't really do too much in reality, because it's a lot about the initiation, about making sure you don't feed away these heroes. I think the trading racks, all of them, Secret is a racks down that ended up happening in the trade. I think they're not actually too sad about this. I think all these weird racks trades going down where both teams start losing buildings all over the playlist, split pushing. I think that actually favors Secret, so even though they're down a barracks, I don't think they're sad about how that trade actually went down, because they want to create chaos, they want to create scenarios where Alliance splits up, where the cores get isolated, and they're able to actually find these pickoffs. And I think that's sort of what Secret has to do. They have to create chaos, they have to Alliance misplay, you know, maybe somebody TP's back goes as opposed to, and they're able to find, able to separate heroes. So I think, you know, despite the number of racks being in favor of Alliance, I don't think Secret is actually mad about, like, the way that bullet exchange went down, all that chaos that happened.
Coming out, but again, the very careful play continues. Alliance charging on out. Crystal Maiden kind of leading the way. It says well up here, but just not able to reach onto anyone. TP's being used, and MP will just keep pushing again the top lane. Sitting on that Maelstrom. Not something else being delivered. Actually, oh yeah, that's right. It's a full Lincolns that he had being worked on this game. So, and the Ember Spirit build, he's not necessarily dishing out crazy damage, I guess, but the idea that he's split pushing, staying alive is definitely real. And that's win condition, perhaps, going back to. So, Lincoln's pickup, you think?
Yeah, I think it's probably a little bit necessary. With the Juggernaut having the Ibza Blade, he can always just get jumped and blown up in the duration of that stun. Like, bubble afterwards, or, you know, the RP even following up. So I think, yeah, the Lincoln's makes it a little bit harder for him to get picked off on the map. The Juggernaut can't just kill him solo, so he can put up these lanes a little bit more aggressively. He's a Magnus node, can't really die to anything else. So I think the Lincoln's pickup is pretty necessary. Yeah, that's sort of the issue with this Ember versus Juggernaut matchup as the game goes later and later. The Ember versus a lot of carries can do a whole lot of work with this magic damage build because they're forced to BKB, and then once their BKB is down, they can just get fighted non-stop by getting, you know, chains. Now that he is 25 with that Ocarina, the Juggernaut's a different story, always has to spin. So you can't really ever get a stage where, oh, I forced out spin. He's not going to have spin for 50 seconds, as a considerably shorter spell. And one of the few heroes that actually does well versus Ember Spirit late game.
I mean, can they catch up here? Like, this... Oh, God, he's a Remnant. Actually, they know he's here, the Ill Scepter. Yeah, they will be able to catch him. He doesn't have a flyback, by the way. He's going to be science up with the Global Science right there. Can they get enough follow-up damage? He has the RP in case. It's not even necessary. No buyback for Ember Spirit. Now, they did get the Aegis in the meantime. So there's a positive, I guess, you could take from it. In fact, who got the Aegis? It looks like Centaur, yeah.
Yeah, he has a Refresh Orb as well in base. He doesn't have it on his hero, which is a little unfortunate. But they have the double Aghanims, potentially stall out.
Tia got caught with the Abyssal Blade, but he pops the BKB. The Stampede activated again with that Axe. A lot of mitigation. Lotus Orb coming out for the Centaur, reflecting a little bit, but not going to be enough mitigation. He does fall. There's that Aegis. In pop though, so they at least should be able to get the turn kill onto him. Trying to get the Witch Doctor as well, not gonna happen. The Centaur will fall again. Good and time. He too is staying dead. You're right, he just bought that instead of the Refresher, but unfortunately he didn't even have it delivered. Timings are not looking good for Secret.
Juggernaut just does so much damage. You can see the TA was able to hit the Juggernaut like two or three times, and it only hit like 100 damage. And the Juggernaut just has so much armor with the Solar Crest onto him as well. It's constantly there. From Hanskin having the Vlads, they have so much armor. This TA can only do so much damage. Whenever you're all physical, all single target hero, and they have all these armor items, but Vlad's actually standing.
Yeah, and might as well. I love this decision. Again, either they know 100% or they don't, they've made up the buyback, but obviously that's not the case. They're going right for it to finish the game right here, right now. Pilai dying now, mid one does port back. Realizing that he's not going to win that race, they got to fight. BKB's popped. This is the last stand right here. Out comes the Abyssal Blade. Study dropping half on the last damage of Loda. It's way too intense. And it looks like they may have just done it. Trying to get the Shrine to help with the Crease push forward as well. He's going to spin through as the buyback, of course, for mid one. Jumping back in. Puffy's also vulnerable. Look at mid one taking it. GG's being called, though. Alliance takes the game. They just got the Aegis. Yet those deaths obviously set up the victory for